हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। माय नेम इज इंजीनियर मीर मसूदिया। आई एम लेक्चरर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सरहज यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ साइंस एंड इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, पेशावर। एज आई एम टीचिंग यू द सब्जेक्ट डिजाइन ऑफ हाइड्रोलिक स्ट्रक्चर, टुडे इज योर लेक्चर नंबर 17 एंड योर कोर्स वीक इज वीक नंबर 9। In lecture number 17, we will study about modes of failure and criteria for structural stability of gravity dams. So, a gravity dam may fail in the following ways. Number one, the dam may be failed by overturning or rotation about the toe. Number two, the dam may be failed by crushing. Number three, by development of tension causing ultimate failure by crushing. And number four, by shear failure called sliding. The dam failure may occur at the foundation plan, that is at the base of the dam, or at any other plan at higher level. So coming to the first topic, that is overturning or the failure due to overturning. If the resultant of all the forces acting on a dam at any of its section passes out the toe, the dam shall rotate and overturn about the toe. Practically, such a condition shall not arise, as the dam will fail much earlier by compression. The ratio of righting movement about toe, that is the anti-clockwise, to the overturning movement about the toe, that is means clockwise, is called the factor of safety against overturning. The factor of safety of overturning is generally vary between 2 to 3. The second is the compression or crushing or failure of dam due to crushing or compression. A dam may fail by the failure of its material, that is the compressive stresses produced may exceed the allowable stresses and the dam material may get crushed. So the vertical direct stress distribution at the base is given by the equation, which is P is equal to direct stress plus bending stress. The total direct stress P, which may be maximum or minimum, is equal to summation V divided by B plus minus MY over I. Summation, that is equal to summation V, is equal to plus minus summation V into E divided by B square into divided by B square divided by B squared by 6. Taking summation V by B is equal is common, we get summation V by B into 1 plus minus 6 E divided by B. So P max or P minimum is equal to summation V divided by B into 1 plus minus 6 E divided by B. Here E is the eccentricity of the resultant force from the center of the base, while summation V is the total vertical force and B is the base width. So P max is equal to summation V divided by B into 1 plus 6 E divided by B, while P minimum is equal to summation V divided by B into 1 minus 6 E divided by B. The maximum stress, that is P max, will be produced on the ends which is nearer to the resultant, as shown in figure 19.7a and B. In this diagram, the vertical stress distribution for the reservoir for full case, when the reservoir is full, is shown. When the reservoir is full, the resultant will be produced towards the or near the toe. This is the total vertical stress, summation B, while this is the horizontal stress, which is summation H. This is the P minimum, which is positive for the when the reservoir is full, and this is the maximum value. So as you can see, when the reservoir is full, maximum stress or compression stress is produced near the toe. Also, if the minimum is negative, as you can see, the maximum compression force is produced at the near the toe, which results in the crushing of the toe, and as a result the structure fails. This is the condition for the vertical stress distribution when the reservoir is empty. When the reservoir is empty, and in this case the resultant will be near the heel, and in this case the maximum positive compressive stress will be produced at the near the heel. If P minimum comes out to be negative, it means that tension shall be produced at the appropriate ends. And if P minimum exceeds the allowable compressive stress of the dead material, generally taken as 3,000 kN per square meter or 30 kg per square centimeter for concrete, the dead may crush and fail by crushing. And this is the end of our today's lecture.